I'm going to introduce Ryan Estes, who's going to rock us.
They're switched on. From the moment they get up, they're ready to go. They're ready to compete. They're in the right frame of mind. They're going to have a great day. They're switched on. I love that. They're switched on. To me, being switched on is also the awareness or recognition that things are going to happen beyond my sphere of influence or control. What I get to control is how I react to it. Somebody was negative, I have a choice. Somebody said something I didn't like, I have a choice. I own myself. And when I'm switched on and I'm in the right frame of mind, I'm not going to get derailed. I have a mission, I have goals. They're written down, they have a deadline.
We're talking, the session's about trends, technology, and transformation, and I can tell you that the trend line is the way we communicate, connect, and collaborate is being forever transformed. And we are at the tip of the iceberg in this evolution. You can no longer control it. So embrace the opportunity to do it differently.
The reality of it is that change is the new normal. We are living in a world where the pace of change is rapidly accelerating. You have external circumstances, pressure, a new normal that just didn't previously exist. Now, I'll tell you, my first 2 years in sales and business development, I didn't even have a computer. We had a recipe box with index cards, and the leads were alphabetized. Imagine how much change we've experienced in that short period of time. I'm not that old. And I would submit that we will see more change beyond our control in the next 24 months than we've seen in that entire time. So this is just a different kind of world that we're living in. It requires a different kind of approach to get to those outcome objectives. And for many of us, that can be anxious and unsettling and nervous and prompt fear and resistance, because we want to go back to a time where we knew how to do everything and it seemed comfortable and normal and we had a routine and it was easy. Those days are gone.
It is my premise that passionate work occurs when the right person in the right job is supported by very intentional and strategic action of the organization and its leadership. So much human potential lies dormant in many of our workforces. And increasingly, the onus is on better leaders and better managers to tap into that potential.
You remember the scene of the movie, it's kind of toward the end of the movie, where he's trying to get his girl back and he rushes in the living room and there's a bunch of women there. And he says, all right, it's got to be in the living room. I'm going to go right here and we're going to do this right now. And she says, stop. You had me at hello. We have our employees at hello. There's never a pinnacle of more elevated engagement than when somebody accepts a job. It's hope, it's optimism, it's excitement, it's enthusiasm. And then what happens? Yeah, reality sets in. Yeah, the reality that there might be a bit of a difference between the expectations and the experience. And so it's so important, all the stuff we're talking about here, to see that through to the other side. If you're switched on, prepared, flexible, confident, a good listener, you don't make promises you can't or don't intend to keep, and you walk in every time with a vision of an outcome objective, and you map your performance to that outcome objective, you're going to be working hard. So why? What's in it for you? Well, let me help answer that question. I'll give you a couple things, and you're right. The first thing is, change helps you. When it's hard, when it's different, when you're being pushed outside of your comfort zone, when you're struggling a little bit to adopt something new that doesn't feel quite right, that means you're learning, you're growing, you're improving, and eventually you're going to be better. And when you're better, you carry that with you the rest of your life. Because nobody Nobody can strip you of your skills and competency. That's you, you own it. So that's the first reason why. Second reason, and this may be a bigger reason, y'all raised your hands when I asked you if you want to have more fun at work. I promise, sales shift will make you more engaged, more fulfilled, and you're going to enjoy coming to work more each and every day, because you're going to get to work around people who begin to associate their time with you with exponentially increasing value. And when you deliver more value and a better experience to your customer, they look forward to your visit. They want to spend more time with you. They're more motivated when you walk through those doors. If you can help them get to where they want to go, they'll help you get to where you want to go.
I'll give you a closing thought. I do think this is the best time ever to be in the practice of people, because I don't think there's ever been a time where going forward talent will have more of a substantive impact on the success of the business. And I will tell you, for me personally, I woke up today and I felt so lucky, because I feel good and I have my health. And I also have people in my life that love me, and I get to love them back. And I got to spend today doing exactly what I love to do for a living. Fill your organization up with people who feel that way about walking through your doors each and every day, and connect them to your higher purpose. And passion, productivity, and performance will go through the roof.